Alright, so this will be a workshop introduced by Angle Academy, and inside this workshop we will see how we can making a business card from scratch. So we will start from designing the 2D layout of this business card, and after that we will go to make a layout, and we will design it in ElbifJob. Then we will go to export this, and we will make a mock-up for this business card. So without further ado, let's get started by opening ElbifJob. And so now in ElbifJob I will open a new scene, and after that this is a new document that will loading now. And for the dimensions we will start to name it the business card, and it will be the front. For the dimensions it will be 10 centimeters, which will be 9 centimeter, and for that it will be 5 centimeter. And because it will be printed, we will say it will be 400. It's range from 300 to 500. And after that, we can say it will be done for now. And control 0 to zoom out. And I want to. So this is the design that we will make today. And this is the front, as you can see. This is the back, and this is the front. Let's start from the front and pick this color. And after that, we will click Alt Backspace to use this color in the screen. And we must unlock this layer and name this layer to be BG background. And after that, we can swap and Alt Control Backspace to fill from this for this background. And after that, we can make these shapes. I want to also to make another layer, and brush will be such as this. And let's try to make this default and X to swap and click B. And we want this one to be hardness of the 0, and let's click one time here, and after that it will be overlay, or let's try to be soft light. I find that overlay or lighting or screen. Alright, so overlay will be fine, and opacity will be such as this, so that make this effect for now. And I will group these layers and name it to BBG, which is background. Then we want to make the shapes from here. So how we can make these shapes? So let's start from a bin and start a new layer. And as you can see, these shapes, we will make a new guideline. So control R and a new guideline from here to here, and make using the B. Or let's try to the rectangle first. Let's see what we have. I will start from a rectangle, and let's duplicate this one, control J, and moving here. And for this one we will try to select this direct selection, or select the boss selection first and moving. So let's try another tool, the direct selection, and it will be like this, and select this one, and let's select this layer which is here, and the direct selection tool, and moving in this direction, and select both and moving here in the x-axis. Let's duplicate layers, and I must say that this version is CS5 of Job. So if you have a version which is maybe later version. Now we, as you can see, this there is the 2020 version. And if you have a newer version, so you can keep following. As you can see, each newer version will be fine. And also, we want to define the colors of these rectangles. And I will pick this lower color and pick another color, which is here. So we have picked two colors. And let's swap. So we will select from here this color to be this, and this color will be this up, which is the foreground. And here also we have to select swap these two colors, and like so. After that, we can select another layer here and select the rectangle, which may be round, and using the radius of 2 pixels. So we can type here 2 pixel, and let's go here to make this layer. And I want to the color to be the same as this one, so the color will be the same as this one, or maybe darker little bit. So it will be little bit dark, such as this, and it should stick to the above. And using the direct selection tool, moving such as this. So what next? We want to add some lights here. So before that, there is some shadows. How we can make these shadows? We will select this layer and going to the effects, right click here, or from effects, this panel or this menus will pop up. And after that, we can select the drop shadow and select this one to be 180. Let's try to 27, and the opacity will be 40, and let's try some values here. Let's see. So we want it to the opacity to be lower, 25 maybe, and we want the distance to be lower, 3 or maybe 4, but the spread will be 8, size will be 5, and this will be fine for now. And also we can hide the guideline. Let's go back, and for the options, we can say that the spread distance will be 2, but we want the spread will be like this. Again, we can go and move this effect, copy layer style, and paste it here. And after that, we have the same, but I can select this layer and move or make another layer. And using the brush, lower, not the pencil, but we want to select the brush using B, and using some brush such as this, and it must be so let's select and after that, we can see its opacity will be lower, maybe 50. And again, we have some other elements. We have the this yellow bar. So how we can make this? we will select the bar which is here, and above that bar we can draw bend tool. Using the bend tool we can draw from here and make selection. And after that alright, so let's see how we can delete this. We can go to this layer and going back here and delete. Here we are, and what we have again, we can select this layer and select the outer, control shift I, invert the selection and delete from here. Alright, this is fine for now, and we have deleted. Let's control Z and add this selection from the shift and add selection and maybe Alt and delete. Delete from here. So we are now done for the shape which is here. Let's make the other shape which is much easier. Before that we have this to be color overlay and color overlay, and this will be yellow. And after that we can going to select this layer which is here, which is here, and make another layer below, and let's select the rectangle. Let's see what we have. So we have the rectangle, and we can go to the direct selection tool. Select the rectangle and using the direct selection tool and select all and width of maybe select one point only here and here and click enter, and we want this layer below every items or all items such as this, and the same color will be here. And I think we are now done. Let's see what we have. So we have some stroke. Let's select this layer. And after that, it will be. So the stroke in all size, we want a drop shadow from the direction. Color will be white. And distance will be maybe 35, spread will be 0, and size will be 2, and I want it to be color of this one, so size will be 1, 2, and distance will be 35, maybe like this, and let's try another mode, maybe soft light, and all right, we will stick for this one and going here and control 0 to zoom out. So we have make the basic shape for our layout. All the other things will be much easier. This is the hardest part inside our tutorial, and later we'll see how we can add the text and add some another icons. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial, and in if you find this tutorial if you find this tutorial helpful for you, you can leave a comment or leave a review inside this class. So see you in the next lesson.